Access for Everyone, Breaking Down Digital Barriers for People with Disabilities. An introduction to digital accessibility for people with disabilities.
When I have my screen reader or braille display, I can access my assignments that my teachers give me easier and just at the same pace that my peers do.
The screen reader and braille display help me do things, but just in different ways.
Students with disability can learn the same way as other kids. They just need equal access.
Having online videos with closed captioning helps me understand all the information to be able to complete my work.
Accessible online learning and other educational programs and services support students across the country and their parents and community members to access online learning and information about what's happening at school. I'm Catherine Lhamon, and I am the Assistant Secretary for Civil Rights at the U.S. Department of Education's Office for Civil Rights. We at the Office for Civil Rights enforce equal access to education, including for students with disabilities, and through ensuring that school programs are accessible to parents and guardians with disabilities. Our goal for this video series is to promote understanding of what digital accessibility is and how to ensure that students and others with disabilities have access to the online tools that are increasingly often an essential part of education. So, what is digital accessibility in the context of education? It's about making sure that anything a school offers using technology is accessible to everyone, including people with disabilities. Students and parents with certain disabilities, such as blindness, low vision, dyslexia, and motor disabilities, may interact with technology and digital content differently from others. Some use screen reader software to have digital content read aloud. Some magnify the screen, change the color contrast, or avoid flashing images. Others navigate the computer using only a keyboard because a mouse doesn't work for them. And some students rely on accurate captions to have access to audio and video content. In addition to technology, the law plays an important role here. The Office for Civil Rights enforces two laws that prohibit discrimination based on disability in education programs and activities. First, Title II of the Americans with Disabilities Act, and second, Section 504 of the Rehabilitation Act. Both these laws predate the internet's wide use, so they don't specifically address online learning or education-related digital communications. But together, these laws require that all public schools and all private schools that receive federal funds ensure that students and others with disabilities enjoy the same benefits and services as those without disabilities. We want to help you make your programs more accessible, and here is one student to explain why.
When I'm able to do things the same as my peers, it makes me feel like good because I'm able to be the same as them. And it just helps me become more independent.
This video was produced by the U.S. Department of Education Office for Civil Rights.
You can find us at ed.gov/OCR or email us at OCR@ED.gov.